I'm about to rank the fuck out these Denzel Curry albums. One of the most, and I mean it with a passion, underrated rappers in the game, Denzel Curry has not missed with a single project. Not one. I have to admit that in the time I spent listening to his works for the last couple of weeks, he became one of my favorite artists of all time, easily between my top 10 and 5 of this past generation. Today I'm going to rank, probably tonight actually, yeah, tonight I'm going to rank 7 of his main projects, which follows as Nostalgia 64, 32 Zell, Planet Shrooms, Imperial 13, Taboo, Zoo, and Melt My Eyes, See Your Future. I know. Unfortunately, I won't be doing Unlock since it is a collaborative album, just like how I did a rant Kid See Ghosts and Watch the Throne on the Kanye video. I'll have a separate video for collab projects, I promised. Anyways, without further ado, let's get into this. Starting off in 7th place, we have the EP 32 Zell / Planet Shrooms. Consisting of about 7 tracks, I'm pretty sure this was the tape that blew him up in the first place. Don't get me wrong, I'm pretty sure Denzel already had some traction in the scene by being involved in the Southern group Raider Clan, along with Space Ghost Perp, but everyone and their mama was bumping Ultimate way back in 2015. Needless to say, this album was a great listen. It's consistent of hard-hitting beats while also being a bit more experimental compared to his previous works, along with hefty bass, borderline drugged-out choruses, and sinister Game Boy head-ass type beats. Denzel effortlessly ripped through track after track, showing no signs of holding back. One thing I realized with a lot of Denzel's earlier works, before his slight shift with the way he approached rap after the Taboo era, was his aggressive and in-your-face cadence. Denzel spits fast. His flow is like a machine gun. Even more, the amount of consciousness and puns he manages to slip in between his bars always leaves me awestruck when done listening. But a lot of the choruses on Zell seem to slow that momentum he builds when rhyming, killing the overall atmosphere and impact of a lot of the tracks. Basically, the choruses on Zell are huge cock blocks. Thankfully, he manages to fix his issue with later works, with the most notable changes being on, again, Taboo and Melt My Eyes. But this can be a pet peeve when trying to submit yourself or submerge yourself into this album, especially with his choruses hitting one emotion, but his rapping striking something else. Of course, not all the choruses are bad, as Ice Age and Lord Vader shows that Denzel is capable of putting out high-quality melodies. Overall, this EP was great from the beginning to the end, and it certainly had me excited in seeing what else Denzel had to offer. I'm feeling an easy 8 out of 10. Being that said, I liked every song off this project. At number 6, we find ourselves with another EP, that being 13. Okay, first off, 13 by some miracle somehow manages to get better and better with each following track. Yes, each track is way better than the one before it. So much so that the last track on this EP, Zeltron 6 Billion, is easily a top 10 Denzel song ever. Being released in 2017, 13 consists of 5 tracks. Straying a bit away from Denzel's typical Memphis trapped infused sound, 13 breaches into more experimental territory, touching upon the industrial hip-hop influence. Through a shit ton of voice alterations, Denzel's flow comes off even gritty on here than ever before. But there are times when he switches it up, as shown on the track Heartless. I think he's even singing for most, if not all, of that particular track. Funny enough, it fucking bangs. Again, I don't know how it's possible, but each track continues to surpass the last one in terms of quality, how hard it hits, and the overall atmosphere set for the entire project. So while Bloodshed comes across as Denzel experimenting, not really knowing what he's doing, Zeltron is his mastering of the new direction. As you can see, I could easily go on for hours raving about Zeltron. The drums, the synths, the wording, it just screams Wu-Tang. As much as I enjoyed this project, being that I like every song in it, its inconsistencies is what brings it down lower than his other works he's put out. Because of this, I'm easily feeling a light score of 9 out of 10. Yeah, that's right. Denzel's work is so good that the album in 6th place already has a score of 9 out of 10. You already know we have a classic coming up. At number 5, we have his most recent work, Melt My Eyes, See Your Future. I don't know what it is with this year, but a lot of the hip-hop albums coming out have been chilled out, laid back, and sprinkled with heavy elements of R&B. I have to admit though, Melt My Eyes is very different than the Denzel Curry I was used to, and after hearing Walkin', I was pretty sure this would be my least favorite project from him. Needless to say, I was happily wrong. Melt My Eyes was filled with a lot of lo-fi beats, a surplus amount of bass, and weird sound effects / synths throughout to give it a natural Denzel feel. With on-point head-snapping beats and vintage-like drums, there were even some jazzy chord progressions sprinkled here and there. As many of the stacked features on this project managed to give it life, The song range and samples used allow this album to develop its own unique sound. I'm especially looking at that Friday Night Funkin' headass track, Zaitoichi. Doesn't it sound like it's from the game? I know I'm not the only one bugging, bro, come on. Melt Your Eyes is an extremely good album, proving that Denzel still has it in him all these years later. While not as eventful as his previous works, it still has a pretty strong fitting in his discography. Feeling a strong 9.1 out of 10. Every song on this album was excellent. Sitting comfortably in fourth place, we have Zoo, Denzel's fourth studio album. Coming off of Taboo, you can clearly hear a difference in style with Denzel's older work and his newer work. Zoo is stacked with way more funkier instrumentals, heavy bass, and lushful trap beats, a bit different from Denzel's older, more dark and grittier sound. Of course, there are still many more experimental tracks like Birds. It seems, however, that Taboo in 13 was Denzel's farewell letter to the Memphis style and a beautiful introduction to his new industrial experimental style. While there's a lot more singing done on Zoo, he still drops a shit ton of verses here and there, often catering to the jungle fever beats and warrior-like energy. While seizing a bit of his usual addictive rapid-fire flow, Denzel instead takes more time with his verses, allowing his delivery to be a bit more clear and tangible. While I would have preferred a little bit more substance with Zoo, as some tracks can feel a bit bland in his vibrant palette, instead I was greeted with energetic rap aimed at moving my body. I enjoy every song off of this project, even the interludes, and I'm feeling an easy 9.3 out of 10. Again, I liked every song off of here. And now for the top 3! Hope y'all are still with me. It's time I show you my top 3 picks in the Curry catalog. In third place is my personal favorite work from Denzel, Nostalgic 64. Damn. Despite being his debut album, Nostalgic 64 would lay the blueprint for the sounds Denzel would use in his later year. Heavy southern-soaked instrumentals, intoxicating synths, and a dark atmospheric vibe, Nostalgic just feels so underground. I live for it. Here, Denzel manages to spit and rip through every track like a sword slicing through flesh. Even as we navigate through the insane amount of bass left in here, the production of Off and Nostalgic actually reminds me of an early Travis Scott. I'm talking Owl Pharaoh. Juicy hi-hats, bubbly 808s, and a lot of bounce, Denzel pays homage to multiple genres of the Southern sound. This allows us to really hone into the dark and moody setting of the South, Violent being a huge example. Nostalgic 64 is Denzel in his natural state. Even when I go back and listen to it, I often miss how gritty and raw he sounds on here compared to what he does in the following years. The era Taboo really did change everything, and listening to his older works makes this more apparent. I'm feeling an easy 9.5 out of 10 with my favorite songs being Intro, Zone 3, Parents, Threats, Mystical Virus, Part 3, The Scream, Widescreen, Nintendo 64, Like Me, Talk That Shit, Benz, and A Day in the Life of Denzel Curry Part 2. At number 2, we have the one and only Imperial. The songs on this album sound like something off of, again, a Travis Scott album, but instead more notably a fine mix between Birds and Rodeo. Again, the beats are dark and moody and have this sort of crystallic charm to it. However, one of the main differences between a Curry and a Travis project is the fact that Denzel usually raps his ass off to make sure those beats are used to the max. Since Travis is more of a producer than a rapper, he takes his beats to new heights, whereas Denzel relishes in making sure his rapping brings out the most in a song. And with this approach to his music, the song slaps so hard. I don't know if it's a Florida rapper thing, but MCs like the late Triple X's Ski Mask also take this approach with their music. I swear these Southern rappers are something else. Throughout all these intense verses, Curry's choruses on this project are psychedelic, with his chants seeming to resemble something from space. Funny enough, this also allows for a sweeter juxtaposition with Denzel's aggressive approach on these songs, making them hit even harder. Ugh, and the end of Naughty Niggas, bro? Oh, I'm black, by the way, if you guys didn't know, so yeah. Anywho, how this guy is never mentioned in the top 10 rappers of this generation is insane to me. It's asinine. There isn't a single bad song on here. I enjoyed everything. And while I may prefer some songs over the other ones, it doesn't diminish this album's quality in any other way. I'm feeling a strong 9.8 out of 10. The song If Tomorrow's Not Here is also a huge indicator that I need to hear Denzel rap on a Tyler beat. Okay, yeah, so I already know what number one is. Y'all already know what it is. Based on what I've been told from y'all, specifically my taste in music, it's weird. So I bet a few of my longer listeners are surprised to see me put Taboo in first place. This is basically the equivalent of me putting Igor as Tyler's best album, which I actually did on the Tyler ranking video. I'm gonna be real though, I had no idea what to expect when it came to this album. Funky, groovy, heavy electronic sounds and bouncy trap beats, Taboo was extremely different compared to the average Denzel Curry project. Broken into three volumes, Taboo touches upon many of Denzel's darker thoughts, fears, and observations. From the corrupt music industry to the strains fame and success have brought to his own personal relationships. Tracks can still go hard, but they have this different energy to them. Here we see the change in Denzel's chemistry. He bids farewell to his iconic fast-spinning flow and settles for hard-hitting bars through a much more practical delivery. Don't get me wrong, Denzel still slides on songs like Sirens, Super Saiyan Superman, and Switch It Up, but what really helps this project resonate in the way that it does is how comfortable Denzel comes across on here. There is no strain, no over-the-topness, or anything extra. Denzel rides out the waves of his music, pause, knowing his own limitation, and uses his skill and knowledge to captivate us through his work. With a solid aesthetic, addictive melodies, and a clear way with his words, Denzel's message manages to come across stronger than it does on any of his other works. I love every track on this project, and to me, it's easily a 10 out of 10. Also, you gotta give Denzel credit for how short his songs are. I hate rappers who make their songs long for no reason. Ugh. Anyways, so y'all, thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed. Seriously, go check out Denzel Curry. If there's any rapper I've talked about or any rapper that I've ranked, you seriously need to check out Denzel. I think I even may make a video on how underrated he is. He has so much to offer. He's a great artist. I love his work, and now I'm a huge fan of him. So you already know I'm going to be making a lot more content of him if the opportunity presents itself. But yeah, so new video coming soon. If y'all wondering why I'm not as active as I wasn't earlier months, it's because your boy is always on Twitter. Arguing with everybody, bro. Arguing with everybody. So yeah. Give your boy a follow over there if you want to. Only if you want to. But yeah, that's about it. I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye-bye!
I'm the truth. Go to sleep, motherfucker. Rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetop. Put that boy to fucking sleep. Stop playing with me, nigga. You gonna learn. I'm the truth.